And remember, God performed miracle after miracle after miracle in front of Pharaoh that should have convinced Pharaoh, you know what? This guy I'm dealing with, this God, is a little beyond me. I need to give up. It should have convinced Pharaoh that, you know what? My high priests and my magicians and so on, they can't match this God. It didn't. Think about it for a minute. If you were in Pharaoh's shoes and you saw all the miracles that God performed on behalf of his people, wouldn't it make you kind of pause and say, maybe this is the wrong school here, I believe, for me to think of it, you know?
He was bent on committing suicide.
As I've said to you before, the first crime that man committed was suicide. Of that fruit, he committed suicide. The last major crime man committed was the day he signed. He attempted to kill God on the cross. And it didn't work. Man is dangerous. This is Paul continuing with the answer to that question. You know, if why does God find fault with someone that, you know, confirms so or hardens their heart? Why does he find fault? He says, no, but man, you are, who are you to question God? Shall the thing formed say to him that formed it, why have you made me into a pot of dishonor? Has not the pot of power over the clay of the same lump to make it to a vessel of honor, like, say, a drinking bottle, or a vessel of dishonor, like a toilet or something like that? But if God is willing to show his wrath, to make his power known, in other words, if God had performed the miracles in front of you that he performed in front of Pharaoh, the question isn't, what is, let's blame God for the way you turned out. No, the question is, you've seen the miracles. What are you going to do? You now have a decision to make. You may have seen a miracle occur in the heart of someone who you found would never come to Christ. That person comes to Christ and you watch the transformation. That's a miracle. And you say, wow, something happened to this person. But I don't care about that. I'm just going to go ahead and do what I've always been doing. That's not very right. That's not very right. When you watch what God has done with the lives of, say, someone like Sam Burgos, we talk about, you have to say, something happened to this man. Something happened to him. Something happened to change his life because he now has a fear of God. This man had a fear of no one before.
Son of Sam.
He was a murderer, a serial murderer.
Son of Sam?
Yes, son of Sam, yeah. So you have seen all these things. They need to convince. Now, don't get me wrong. Miracles and seeing miracles is not the solution. The Israelites saw miracle after miracle in the desert, and some didn't believe. So, I'm not saying miracles are necessary to believe. I'm not saying they should wake you up. They should make you think, what's going on here? It says, but if God is willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, he has endured much long suffering, the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction, and he might have known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy, which he has prepared unto glory, even us, the church, whom he had called, not of the Jews only, but also of the Gentiles. In other words, God pulled his church out of both Jews and Gentiles. Remember, God has separated three groups of people. The Jews, and by default created the Gentiles, and then he created the church. Composed of both Jews and Gentiles. Arthur, Wesley, Arthur, they're all a bunch of, you know, religious fanatics.
You got that wrong. They love to mix up words. They love to tell you. They love to, as I just pointed out, you put the responsibility of proof on the other person. In other words, they can come up and say, I feel like a cat. Now you have to prove to me I'm not a cat.
No, you didn't. You have no responsibility to me. If I think I'm a cat, I'm nuts.
Get a 5150 out.
Yes. Isn't that situation addressed in the second volume of the Quran? One where it's
the hadith?
Yes, where it says it's okay to kill.
Correct. It is done to hell.
To lie to them.
Yes. Correct.
But that's never publicized.
A lot of radical Muslim clerics take advantage of the fact that most people are not aware of what's in the surah and what's in the hadith. And then, to make matters worse, as you know, there are several versions of the hadith. It would be like if we had the Hebrew Testament, the Old Testament, and then we had several versions of the New Testament, all written by different people. And so some people might say, so when you say the hadith, I use only the al-Bukhari version of the hadith because that is the version that's accepted by the Wahhabi sect of Saudi Arabia. But, you know, there are different authors of different hadiths. Yes.
I thought there was some kind of version that they presented to the non-Muslim to make themselves look good and peaceful.
That's the surah. The surah, when you read the surah, it's actually some of the most beautiful poetry in the world. It's all wonderful and nice. It doesn't have any of the violence. It has minimal amounts of violence in it. It doesn't have the violence that you normally think of. It's a surah.
Which one is it?
Both the surah and the hadith, to my knowledge, say that. Yes.
Is the content significantly different? Or
both radically different. Between the surahs and the hadith. Yeah.
No, I mean the different hadiths.
The different versions of the hadith. Yes, very different.
Yeah.
Very different. In fact, the Shiites almost don't use the same hadith as the.
What search term do you use to Google to find this section?
The hadith,
the
al-Bukhari.
The lie and the kill.
Yeah.
Okay. What search term do we put in to find that area? People ask us, well, where's your source document?
Oh, I got you.
What'd you say? Well,
yeah. Okay. But then, gotcha. Well, I usually
something, and it tells you to kill them.
Yeah.
That's
well, it shouldn't
didn't start with the 60s. I did think in the 1960s, I was referring to the 1760s. It didn't start with the It started. I don't think we will ever see a Queen Victoria again. Having said that,
Scriptures, and he said, God has already
he's trying to tell them the church is not an accident. It's not an afterthought. It's not that God said, oh, I forgot about the Gentiles. What are we going to do about it? No, that's not what happened here. He's showing them that this was all part of God's plan. And he goes on and says, you who are not my people, they shall be called the children of the living God in Israel. In other words, the reason that you and I were saved is because we are going to be, like the Jews, a trophy of his grace. It shows you how gracious he is, that he chose the children of a con artist, and now he's choosing the Gentiles. Basically, we were savages. We're always killing each other. I mean, we're really good at that, not good at too many other things. Look at how gracious God has been. Probably the most brilliant human mind that ever lived, I would say after Paul, would be Isaac Newton. Even Albert Einstein acknowledged he could not have done his work without the preparation foundation laid by Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton was a Gentile. God loves all of his children, and he's giving them a chance to come to him. And if you say, I don't want to have anything to do with you, I want to do, to quote George Orwell, I want to do whatever I want to do to whoever I want to do it, whenever I want to do it, wherever I want to do it, as often as I want to do it. George Wald, one of the most brilliant molecularist biologists who ever lived. He was the guy that figured out, yes. He was the guy that figured out the code, the DNA code, to know what letters in the code. You know, each letter you see in the DNA code stands for a chemical. A is for adenine, C is for cytosine, G is for guanine, and B is for thymine. And they code for different amino acids. So when you look at a genetic code, and it says, you know, all you see is A, T, C, G, D, D, and goes on. And then just a bunch of those four letters repeated over and over and over and over again. It's a code for certain amino acids. And as you know, different amino acids put together make different proteins. And we knew that we were looking at this vast code, and we knew it translated into proteins, but we couldn't figure out the translation. George Wald figured out the translation. He devised a series of brilliant experiments to figure it out. God gave him that insight. Most likely was a homosexual, based on my reading of his life story, but he was definitely a godless man. So why would God give that privilege and honor to a godless man? Trophies of his grace. Would you have done it? No. But God did. God did.
Wasn't your conversion have something to do with you seeing evidence when you're a non-believer? So you went through the same thing?
Yes. Yes. Yes, God.
There's another code, or another state that applies to what this other guy just said. All men are created equal.
Yes.
He said that, is that cold?
What's that? What's that?
Cold. 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 Say it well, Pete.
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, good. you know, people accuse
you. You can say what you want to do to me. I have a thing, I have six things.
You know, and people are accusing you of having a sense of humor.
Yeah. Very smart people. You mentioned three. Are you in the top five?
No.
I can't resist that one.
No, I would probably put Johann Kepler, Copernicus, Johann Kepler, Polish astronomer, and Isaac Newton, Antoine Lavoisier, who was my personal hero. And Robert Boyle. They were chemists. Antoine Lavoisier was a French chemist, and Robert Boyle was his English counterpart. Those are the people that were my heroes, and I was
accepted the Jews or separated the Jews as my chosen people, but I know a lot of them are going to reject. So it wasn't like he selected them thinking that they were all going to accept him. He knew beforehand that they were going to reject him. He says a remnant will always be there. And that has been the case. We have always had Messianic Jews. From the time of Christ to now, we have always had a remnant.
They were the ones that followed
Christ.
Has always wanted to achieve his own righteousness.
Correct. He says, so what shall we say then? That the Gentiles, which did not follow after righteousness, have attained righteousness, even the righteousness of faith? They have. But again, you're not understanding. He is a father. You see, we see God as a loving father. Muslims see God as a judgmental judge, as a judge, meeting out punishment. We see him as a father who is patient. He's willing to wait on us to get it right, to understand what is going on. He does mean our punishment, yes, he's not, no parent can forever reward a child. I think at some point, punishment has to come. Well, let me go over. We're going to start with the bottom of page 6. And I'm amazed that we actually got 14 verses then. Must be doing something wrong. we are great. The next few verses, will bring us to the end of chapter 9. And then we'll go into chapter 10. I'm amazed. Hey, got guys, two lessons, and we got a chapter. Sometimes it takes us two lessons to get one verse then. But anyway, let's go to the Lord. Other civilization on earth would have been as generous